Hey everyone, Paul Bowden here from the Office of Mac engineering team here in Building 36 out of Redmond, Washington. So in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about how to run Office 365 for Mac in complex network environments. So let's get started. So even though Office for Mac is a set of applications that get installed locally on your machine, there are a whole set of backend services that those apps reach out to get greater functionality. The most obvious examples I can give you are things like OneDrive for file storage, and also contact to the Office Content Delivery Network so the Office can get its updates. However, you may not know that some features within the apps, like PowerPoint Designer and the language translation feature inside Word, also need to be able to communicate to backend services. It sends the content up, it gets translated, and then the data comes back down again. Of course, Office is also designed to run in a completely disconnected environment. So let's say if you're on an airplane without any Wi-Fi, of course you'll get to use most of the basic functionality. But for some of those features, they won't be available when you're disconnected. The same can be said for those networks that you may be on that have restrictions on contacting various URLs. You may not be able to get all the functionality within Office. If you're working in a large, complex organization, there may be a dedicated networking team there, and they may ask you for a list of the endpoints and ports that Office uses to get access to its services. Well, if you're in this situation, you can head over to aka.ms/endpoints365, and you can download the latest version of the Whitepaper that lists out all of the endpoints that Office needs. For the most part, you can just simply hand that Whitepaper over to the networking team, and it should be fairly obvious as to what they need to do next. So let's take a quick peek. Okay, so here I'm gonna just run up Safari and navigate my way to aka.ms, endpoints, 365, and then that's gonna redirect me to the white paper. So in here, I have annotation for each of the Office for Mac apps, and then I have a designator as to what the URL type is, whether it's hard-coded in the application or if it's dynamic. And then I have several sections on the major scenarios of Office, and then I drill into specific features like Smart Lookup. And then if you scroll close to the end of the document, you can also see that there's a pretty rich document history in there, so you can see what's changed month to month. If some of these endpoints are restricted on your network, you may see different effects within Office. One effect may be that you just see an error message or a particular feature not working. Another type of issue you might see is where you see a delay, a beach ball, or a hang when performing an operation. If you see this, it's useful to get out your stopwatch and time the length of the hang. If it's either 45 seconds or 120 seconds, then that's pretty indicative of a network communication problem. 45 and 120 are the typical timeouts that we use for network requests. In cases where I'm troubleshooting, where I think the network is at play, I use a couple of different strategies to try and narrow down the issue. First of all, and assuming I'm not violating any company security policy, I might try and tether my Mac to my iPhone. So instead of using the company's internal network, I'm actually using the mobile carrier's network, which is generally unrestricted, to perform that same operation to see whether the issue actually goes away. If I find the issue has gone away, then what I'll do is back on my internal network, I'll open up a network analyzer. Personally, my tool of choice is Charles Proxy, and you can get a free trial of that from charlesproxy.com. I've downloaded and installed Charles on my machine, so let's take a look at what it can do. Okay, so I'm going to launch Charles, which is indicated by the vase icon. And in the main UI, I see a left and a right area. I'm going to launch PowerPoint. And I'm just going to get to that opening splash screen. And now we're going to look at the actual traffic that PowerPoint has generated during that open sequence. And I can see all of the different endpoints here. I can also change to a sequence view so I can see the exact kind of timing that each request was made and the return code. Okay, so one of the problems you can see is there's a lot of unknowns here. I can see the endpoint, but I can't really see the content. It's all encrypted. And that's because Office uses all HTTPS communications. So what I can do here is I can go into Charles's SSL proxying mode by first of all installing a Charles root certificate. So this will install the root cert in my login keychain. I have to open it up here, and then I specify that I always want to trust this certificate. And I enter my admin credentials, and that one is now trusted. So it's really important to understand that installing a third-party root certificate on your machine and trusting it is not really something that you want to do every day. So I'd thoroughly recommend that you perform this on a test machine, and once you're done with your investigation, you should either clean up and delete that root certificate, or you may even want to just flatten and rebuild your machine. One other thing that I need to do here is go into Charles's SSL proxying settings and just specify that I want to proxy all traffic. Now with that done, I'm just going to clear my Charles session, and I'm going to just stop the PowerPoint process, and I'll head back and relaunch PowerPoint. And let's see what difference that's made. Okay, back to the same screen. You can see that now when I open up the structure, I can see the exact paths and the exact data that is being sent to and received back from the network. And in the top section of the right window, I can see the request. This is a particular query string. And then in the bottom section, I can see the headers that were returned and different representations of the data that came back from that request. So that's pretty cool. Let me show you a couple of other scenarios. For example, let's look at what happens on the network when Office gets activated. So here I've entered my password to log in, and Office is activated behind the scenes. Now, if we look in our white paper, we know that ols.officeapps.live.com is actually the endpoint. And here is kind of some really verbose information about the license that I'm using. And now finally, what I want to show you is what happens if a URL is blocked. Here I'm in PowerPoint's doc stage, and I'm going to just search for a template for a calendar. And it says we couldn't find any templates that matched. Kind of odd, because that's a pretty common template name. Well, in fact, back in Charles proxy here, I can see that, here it is. There is a block on templateservice.office.com. And that's the reason why this particular feature is failing. I hope this video was useful for you and you understand a little bit more about behind the scenes with Office and networking. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe if you want to get notifications of new content. Take care, and I'll see you next time.